the state of Michigan, people are talking about the health status and the declining physical fitness levels of Michigan citizens. As we strive for Michigan to be healthier and stronger, it's important more than ever to have organizations and individuals that step up, encourage, provide tools for all of us to take better care of our own personal well-being. Each year, Michigan Fitness Foundation, the Governor's Council on Physical Fitness, Health, and Sports, recognizes Michiganders that are dedicated to make a difference in their own health, the health of their employees, and the health of their communities through the Governor's Fitness Awards. While we can't host the Governor's Fitness Awards in our usual fashion due to the pandemic, we are glad you are here to join us as we share our stories and celebrate successes of this year's nominees in our first virtual awards presentation. May you be inspired to live healthier lives and be proud to be a Michigander.
The Extraordinary Organization Award honors organizations with an exemplary record of giving and stewardship that focuses on improving the environment where people live, work, and play. Since 2012, Operation Fit has focused on decreasing rates of childhood obesity while inspiring kids to be more active. Developed by the collaborative efforts of Bronson Battle Creek, Battle Creek Community Foundation, Battle Creek Family YMCA, community agencies, organizations, and the philanthropic community, this award-winning program teaches Calhoun County children the importance of health, fitness, and nutrition.
Okay, my name is Don Schills. We're from Battle Creek, and I'm the Operation Fit program lead. Operation Fit was created by the giving nature and stewardship of a lot of organizations. So to start with, three of our organizations are the developers and funders of Operation Fit, and that's Bronson Battle Creek Community Partners, the Battle Creek Community Foundation, and then the Regional Health Alliance. So when you put all of those organizations together, we've created a really nice package of resources, services, and funds that really help us to improve our schools' wellness environments.
My name is Mary Amawari from Battle Creek, Michigan, and I am one of the Operation Fit managers. Operation Fit has many opportunities that we provide at our participating schools and in our Battle Creek community. Some of our initiatives that we have to increase physical activity are, but definitely not limited to morning movement, active recess, our mileage club program. We participate in walk to school days. We have our YMCA staff fitness, where we welcome our staff at our different schools to participate in different fitness activities. And we also participate with our Battle Creek Family YMCA with Family Fitness Night, where we invite the community to come and do a variety of activities as well.
Project Healthy Schools is a community University of Michigan collaboration designed to reduce childhood obesity and improve the current and future health of Michigan's youth. Students participating in PHS have demonstrated improvements in health behavior and cardiovascular risk factors. Using interactive, evidence-based lessons, children learn about topics that include food culture, creating balanced meals, the importance of physical activity, the influence of food advertising, and the role of dietary fats. Through education and wellness activities, PHS enables middle school students to increase physical activity, eat healthier, and establish lifelong healthy habits. Since 2004, PHS has impacted over 129 schools, 76,000 students, and 87 Michigan communities.
My name is Jean Du Russell Weston. I'm from the University of Michigan, and I'm the manager of Project Healthy Schools. Okay, so Project Healthy Schools is a community University of Michigan collaboration, and we're designed to improve the current and future health of middle school youth. We do that by partnering with schools to provide health education and then to help to change the school environment so that it's healthier and it supports the healthy choices that we're teaching the kids in the classes. This whole program is about volunteers It's about donations. It's the ultimate volunteer opportunity or donation opportunity for people that are philanthropists. So, you know, foundations, Michigan Medicine, all these people are just giving of the resources. Well, community education opportunities are really built in, I think, with Project Healthy Schools because we are working in the hub of the community, which is the school. And ideally, the way this works is, you know, children become educated. So we provide the building blocks of how to eat healthy, how do you increase your physical activity, and then we have lessons that they can take home so that they can go with their parents to the grocery store and help pick out the choices of food that they learned that are healthy. You know, they're using their time and talent to give this opportunity to the kids to learn about healthy eating and physical activity.
Todd Turner's youngest daughter was born with Down syndrome and then diagnosed with autism. While there was no shortage of programs centered on physical, speech, and occupational therapy, he found fitness options for the special needs community non-existent. Research shows low fitness levels and obesity in the Down syndrome community are attributed to sedentary lifestyles, lack of social and recreational opportunities, and/or low motivation to be physically active. Determined to help his daughter and others like her, Todd partnered with his brother Paul, and together they started Team Guts.
My name is Todd Turner. I live in Berkeley. I'm one of the owners of Team Guts and a trainer and instructor. Team Guts is a 501c3, a nonprofit organization that's dedicated to improving the lives of those with special needs. Team Guts offers year-round health and fitness programs, including one-on-one training, group classes, sports programs, and summer camps to children, teenagers and adults with special needs and disabilities. No family is ever turned away as we scholarship those that need financial assistance. Athletes, non-athletes, and one of our saying is there's an athlete in all of us. Well, Team Guts is about inclusion, so we accept everyone and we welcome everyone. So those with special needs or disabilities, they're not discriminated against. We welcome them into Team Guts.
The Outstanding Event Award honors active events rich in community spirit that offer inclusive physical activity opportunities for all athletes regardless of age or ability. Founded in 1957, the Greater Flint Olympian and Canusa Games are a Flint and Genesee County tradition. Recently, Crim Fitness Foundation assumed responsibility of the games with the intention of combining the rich history of the Crim with the long-standing tradition of the games. With more than 75,000 athletes ranging in the age from 8 to 80, competing in games like tennis, soccer, hockey, swimming, and more, the games have produced numerous professional and semi-professional athletes. Though participants do not need to be star athletes to join the fun, there are opportunities for everyone to play. An international competition between Flint, Michigan and Hamilton, Ontario, the Canusa Games rotate between the cities each year. Greater Flint Olympian athletes chosen to compete are then paired with host families. Experience the friendship is the motto, and it is most fitting as the prize goes beyond the usual bragging rights associated with a sports competition. Canusa athletes also forge new friendships, create lasting memories, and experience meaningful cultural exchange.
My name is Sharon Davenport. I work for the Crim Fitness Foundation. My title is Program Director for Physical Activity, Sports, and Nutrition, and our event is the Greater Flint Olympia and Canusa Games. The Greater Flint Olympia and Canusa Games started over 60 years ago here in the Flint and Genesee County area. Over the last 63 years, we've had 75,000 kids and adults participate in the program. It's amazing to me what we can do with just the simple offering of here's basketball and teaching those kids how to play basketball. So, I mean, it's all for the kids, and I just love seeing the smiles on their faces.
Since 2012, the Livonia Park Run is a free run and walk that takes place every Saturday at the city's Bicentennial Park. What is a park run? It is a free weekly community event that is part of the global park run community. Park runs can be found in 22 countries around the globe, and the Livonia Park Run was the first park run event in the United States. Managed by a dedicated group of volunteers with support from the city of Livonia, they offer camaraderie, fun, community spirit, and healthy living in an inclusive environment where there is no time limit and no one finishes last.
My name is Tim Gallagher, and I'm the Parkrun USA ambassador for Livonia Parkrun. Livonia Parkrun supports the community at large by really welcoming every member of the community. Anybody that wants to get outside, get some fresh air, get some exercise is welcome to come to Livonia Parkrun. We have a very open, friendly community that really takes care of new people. Anyone who's scared of running a 5K, who's never done it before, we have a website, we have a Facebook page, anyone can come ask questions, how does it work, will I be, you know, welcomed, and yes, you will be. We are very, Livonia Parkrun really is accessible for everyone, whether you're an athlete or a non-athlete. We welcome anybody, no matter young, old, disabled, never run a 5K before, we're just happy to have you come out and try to get some exercise with us.
The Meyer State Games of Michigan is a multi-sport, Olympic-style event that welcomes athletes regardless of age or ability. For the past decade, the event has hosted over 63,000 athletes from every county in the state in 40-plus Olympic or Pan American sporting events, bringing over $3 million in spending to the region. With the support of corporate partners, thousands of volunteers bring the event to life each year. Like the Olympics, the games include an opening ceremony that allows thousands of spectators to witness the parade of athletes, lighting of the cauldron, and experience great entertainment.
My name is Eric Engelbarts, and I'm the executive director of the Meyer State Games of Michigan. We have 40-some events. We have over 10,000 athletes per year without the support of volunteers as well as the corporate community as well. So we have great partners in a lot of our sponsors, including Meyer, but then also thousands of volunteers that come out. So each one of these 40 different sporting events are ran by a volunteer sports committee. They get out there, that put on the track event, that award the medals, and essentially make this event go. So we couldn't do it without the greater Grand Rapids, West Michigan community. Well, one of the greatest things is that I've been here since the beginning. You know, it came from an idea to a business plan to now we've celebrated 10 years and over 63,000 athletes coming out. When I look back on it, there's so many different memories. Every single year is just a little bit different. Just the overall accomplishment of being able to make it over 10 years and really be able to include over 10,000 athletes from across the state is something that I'm proud of.
The Active Community Award honors a community that has increased opportunities for physical activity, designed and built on the ground changes that lead to safe, inviting spaces. This community has also created and implemented policies to sustain their efforts for the long term. Kalamazoo's journey toward becoming a more connected city, both physically and socially, began during their most recent master planning process. A priority goal is to have complete transportation networks that connect schools, parks, and hubs of commercial activity. By building these networks, residents are empowered to use alternative modes of transportation. In 2019, the city invested $1 million to build and improve 8 miles of sidewalks and included input from walking audits with the Disability Network to offer vital feedback and perspective. In 2020, the city is working on expanding the Kalamazoo River Valley Trail, a paved non-motorized path that currently connects to several parks and downtown, with plans to connect the Kalamazoo Farmers Market.
My name is Rebecca Kick. I'm the Director of Community Planning and Economic Development for the City of Kalamazoo. We love to engage the community in our planning processes in the City of Kalamazoo. We do as much as we possibly can to make sure that our residents feel safe on sidewalks and can get to parks and trails and recreational spaces. And so we engage them often and early in projects to make sure that we are getting it right for them. We think that by doing events like Walking Wednesdays, where we have residents who've identified places that they think need to be improved, is a way that you can touch base with your residents and really know how safe they feel. I think what's exciting about the City of Kalamazoo to live, work, and play is that we have a lot of big city type amenities that draw people in, but we also have this really great balance of nature. We've got the river, we've got trails, we've got preserves that can help you keep that really active lifestyle while living in a city that has museums and great restaurants and fun places for your family to visit.
Since 1898, motorized vehicles have been banned on Mackinac Island. This makes the island an active community by default, as feet, bicycles, and horses are the only methods of transportation. The City of Mackinac Island offers year-round recreational opportunities that encourage, support, and convey a healthy, active lifestyle for residents, and does so with the unwavering support of the island's hotels, restaurants, churches, schools, nonprofit organizations, in Mackinac Island State Park.
My name is Margaret Dowd. I am the mayor of Mackinac Island, Michigan. I think it's important for them to maintain exercise and to enhance their health. And Mackinac is a very natural place because we don't have cars. So either we're going to ride a bicycle, we're going to walk. In the wintertime, we do have snowmobiles, but snowmobiles help us get to a point where we can cross-country ski or snowshoe. It's a very natural place. And so planning to get the different exercises and physical activities in place is very important. We need to keep all our residents healthy, from the school children right up to the senior citizens. And I think that's very, very important to our community.
As a safe routes to school leader in Michigan, the City of Traverse City collaborates with partners across sectors on innovative policies, planning, and programs to improve school accessibility and neighborhood connections. It embraces a systems approach that is changing the odds in favor of more happy, healthy, ready-to-learn kids. Putting kids first includes making it possible for kids to get around town safely.
Traverse City is really a role model community because we're very progressive in the things that we do to promote an active lifestyle. We invest in sidewalk infrastructure, we have Hickory Hill Ski Lodge, we have a lot of activities that really get people out, not just in the summertime when it's beautiful weather, but in the wintertime as well. So we make sure that we're a role model in snow removal, in services, and all things that we can do to provide a culture that promotes walking, biking, and getting outside. Traverse City is an amazing place to live, work, and play because we encompass all three of those aspects into our daily living. We're an active community that promotes people connecting to their resources and to each other because we care about everybody that lives here, that visits here, and that works here.
The Healthy Workplace Award recognizes Michigan companies that create workplace wellness programs so their employees have access to resources to be fit, healthy, and more productive. Since 1938, Blue Cross Blue Shield of Michigan has been on a mission to increase access to affordable health care, enhance the quality of care patients, receive and improve the health of Michigan citizens and communities. In the workplace, they extend their mission to their employees with their Be Well Wellness program to support work-life balance.
My name is Mary Ryan, and I'm the Wellness Coordinator for Blue Cross Blue Shield of Michigan. Blue Cross Blue Shield of Michigan provides and administers health benefits for members who reside in Michigan, as well as Michigan headquartered group whose members reside outside of the state. We offer a variety of programs that support work-life balance, especially our Blue Space program, which is provides flexible and mobile work options, so you can work 5 days out of the office or 2 to 5 days out of the office, whatever you choose that works best for you. We find this through technology. We are still meeting our business outcomes, but we're able to provide that flexibility. Blue Cross Blue Shield of Michigan believes in fostering employee wellness, knowing that our employees that are engaged and are participating in the wellness programs, they're healthier, productive, and also it assists with recruiting and retaining high quality talent.
Lax is a company that has a forward-thinking, risk-taking mentality that creates innovative, groundbreaking components and systems to the automotive trim market with a deep-rooted devotion to their employees and their community. To keep employees healthy, safe, and productive, athletic trainers are available in the plants to provide treatment as well as ergonomic recommendations. By creating a culture of wellness within the organization, employees understand that Lax truly cares about them and wants them to live healthy lives.
My name is Amy Dennis. I'm the Wellness Coordinator and I work at Lax Enterprises Incorporated. Our company believes in fostering employee wellness because we're a family-based company. They always believe in taking care of their employees every step of the way and treating their employees like they are family. So the wellness program at Lax has really affected the well-being of their employees and their family members by just encouraging a culture of wellness within their workplace and encouraging them to go home and make healthy decisions when they're at home with their family members. I know employee giving is huge with our employees. They have such generous hearts and they love giving back to the community. Employees have actually either raised or donated over $1.3 million to local nonprofits since 2003. So they're always looking for a new way to do fundraisers or potlucks or some sort of employee giving, and just really always looking to give back to the community in some way.
Spectrum Health Lakeland is a not-for-profit, community-owned health system serving Southwest Michigan. They have invested in a strategic wellness plan with two employee programs designed to support the whole person in their wellness journey. Through these programs, team members have lost thousands of pounds, reduced blood pressure, reversed diabetic trends, eliminated medications, and increased knowledge of healthy lifestyle habits. Promoting health is not only part of the employee wellness program, it is part of the Lakeland mission to improve health, inspire hope, and save lives.
I am Melissa Hahn, Director of Employer Services at Spectrum Health Lakeland. So Spectrum Health Lakeland is a not-for-profit, community-owned health system serving Southwest Michigan with a full continuum of care and wellness services, including 3 hospitals, outpatient surgery center, cancer center, and 48 physician practices. Spectrum Health Lakeland offers a wide variety of health education opportunities, such as healthy cooking classes, fitness classes, disease-specific education, stress and time management classes. We also offer mental health first aid and self-defense classes. We have a high participation rate in our health challenges, whether the challenges are activity-based, such as Walk the Mackinac, nutrition-based, such as Eat the Rainbow, or mindfulness-based, such as a gratitude challenge. Our workplace wellness program has impacted our employees' well-being by helping create awareness of our individual health status, providing health coaching and care management to support each of our unique health journeys, to help set goals, to identify and remove barriers to improving our health, and connecting us with providers who care. It has been an honor to be a part of our team members' health journeys. We have witnessed a reduction or elimination of medications, experienced a better quality of life, and have grown into a healthier organization. As Spectrum Health Lakeland employees engage in and live healthy lives, we are better equipped to help their families and our community be as healthy as they can be.
Brewing with a 15-gallon soup pot, Larry Bell sold his first commercial beer in 1985. Family-owned and independent Bell's Brewery has been creating unique and inspired craft beer in Michigan ever since. Brewing beer is demanding work that takes passion, dedication, discipline, and camaraderie. It is in that same spirit that Bell's support its employees. Bell's places a high value on family and community, and they believe when their employees are making healthy choices, they are living healthier lives while setting an example for others.
I'm Sarah Burhans, and I'm the Wellness Coordinator at Bell's Brewery. Bell's Brewery got its start about 35 years ago in 1985 in just a soup kettle in a quest to make better beer. While a lot has changed here, one thing that has not changed is our commitment to quality and our commitment to our employees. Our workplace wellness program supports a healthy and active culture through lots of different things. We have workshops, we have events and challenges, we bring our dogs to work, we have a community garden. We have numerous creative ways that we bring wellness into our workplace, and it's all supported by a very engaged wellness committee. The reward is seeing employees have the tools and resources they need, whether it's through gaining control of their physical health or being able to buy their first house, but being able to see them feel successful in their life.
Born out of Pier and Birgit, Lorenzen's Kitchen in Howell, Michigan over 60 years ago, Kim Trin has grown into a global organization that formulates and manufactures innovative process chemical specialties for nearly every sector of manufacturing with operations worldwide. In addition to their comprehensive benefits package, Kim Trin supports employee health and wellness with a variety of programs to help their employees eat healthy and move more, and includes biannual on-site health screening and coaching. Kim Trin is also known for its community support. They also believe in the importance of cultural exchange by offering paid international exchange programs for children of employees. Consistently ranked as one of the best places to work, they are driven by a culture of excellence and have created an organization of collaboration, curiosity, and support to ensure the long-term success of their employees.
My name is Kyla Crawford. I'm an administrative assistant and volunteer wellness team leader at Kim Trin Limited Partnership. At Kim Trin, we are interested in our employees' physical health, but we're also interested in their emotional and mental health. So we have a program that's called the Kim Walk, and employees are encouraged to take a walking break 2 times per day. There's a chime that goes off over the PA at 10 a.m. and 3 p.m. and it just reminds employees to stand up, step away from their desk, and go for a walk. We also have a couple other programs. We have a lunch break yoga that runs twice a month, where several employees just meet in a conference room and we do about a 10-minute yoga session. You could do it in your office clothes, so there's no need to bring a special mat or clothing. It's just a stand-up yoga session. And then we also do a 7-minute workout class that we offer once a month. Get a little more movement out of that one and just encourages employees to exercise and move while they're at work. Kim Trin believes in fostering employee wellness because we know that the employee works best when they are mentally, emotionally, and physically healthy.
Founded in 1885, Lansing Board of Water and Light is a municipally owned public utility that provides in water and electric services and utility products throughout Greater Lansing. With a holistic approach, BWL's Be Well for Life Health and Wellness Program focuses on physical, mental, environmental, and financial and educational wellness to help their employees, retirees, and their families live healthier lives. For 135 years, BWL has focused on creating a healthy and sustainable environment for their employees and the community they serve.
My name is Dan Barnes. My title is Human Resources Advisor, and I work for the Lansing Board of Water and Light. So for us, employee wellness is a part of how we think employees should be treated. So it's just a matter of providing employees opportunities for wellness, to be able to be happier in their lives. If they're happier in their lives, it translates to better workplace performance. We think that's how we kind of keep people here. It's how we keep people healthy. It's how we recruit and attract the best talent. We do things like after work classes. We offer yoga. We do all of these different things to be able to not only give employees the opportunity to participate in these wellness plans, but hopefully take something home to their family and be a part of the community. For us, being owned by the ratepayers of the city or the citizens of Lansing, we think it's important to be able to also offer and interact with the community in a lot of those. So when we do things like the 5K and things like that, usually when we host those events, not only is it an opportunity for wellness for our employees and gives them a goal, but it also gives the kind of the community to be able to see that it's important to us. So if we can kind of help foster that creative culture and that wellness culture for an employee at work, hopefully they can take that home and vice versa.
Serving organizations statewide, 44 North specializes in group employee health benefits. By leading the Health E Revolution, they have helped Michigan organizations save millions in healthcare premiums while adding value, cost savings, wellness plans, and employee engagement tools. 44 North provides their cutting-edge products and services in their comprehensive employee benefits package. With locations in Cadillac, Saginaw, Marquette, Granville, and Grand Rapids, 44 North is focused on motivating and supporting employees, their family, and clients across Michigan to become and stay healthy.
My name is Amber Nichols, and I am the wellness coordinator at 44 North. Our company believes in fostering employee wellness. Really, it trickles down from our CEO. Brian Cote is a huge supporter of wellness, incorporating that even into our mission statement, so improving the lives we touch and leading the healthy revolution. We know that it's the right thing to do, and we just care about our employees. Our wellness program helps to provide a proper work-life balance for our employees by allowing them to work from home a few days a week. And we even have the ability to bring in pets to the office, and children for that matter. We can kind of put those in the same category, and they're allowed to bring those here throughout the day. Our worksite wellness program provides a healthy, active culture by providing our employees with stand-up desks and an on-site fitness center. We know that sedentary behavior is one of our highest risks, yet most modifiable risk areas. So we really just encourage those employees to stand up, use those desks, and in the summer you might even catch them playing kickball for a recess at work day. Each month we pick two activities, one to improve the lives we touch and one to lead the healthy revolution. That could be hosting a book drive for local schools. We do regular blood drives, bringing in a financial counselor to help with money management for our employees, sponsoring runs, really just making sure that we're living out that mission statement 12 months out of the year.
In a town of 11,000 on the border of Michigan and Indiana, the Sturgis Police and Fire Department serve their community with commitment, honor, and integrity. Because of their unique location, they serve on specialized countywide and multi-jurisdictional teams, including the St. Joseph Major Crimes Task Force, St. Joseph County Area Narcotics Team, and Special Response Team. To keep officers physically and mentally fit, the City of Sturgis has established an internal model of health and fitness. To achieve this, a nationally certified and state-licensed strength and condition specialist athletic trainer designs and coaches public safety professionals through a wellness program that includes individual and group training sessions, cardiovascular, plyometric, strength, power, and technical fitness training, as well as injury and chronic condition recommendations. Because their work is physically and psychologically demanding and often dangerous, a baseline concussion testing protocol is offered to assess balance, brain function, concentration, memory, and reaction time, and concussion symptoms. To support healthy eating, a nutritionist is available to ensure all are engaged, informed, and empowered. The goal of the City of Sturgis Police and Fire Department is to ensure their dedicated professionals are as healthy as possible so they can have long, positive, and rewarding careers with healthy, vibrant, and sound retirements.
So my name is Jim Leoy, and I am the Tactical Fitness Coordinator for the Sturgis Fire and Police Department, Sturgis, Michigan. With our tactical fitness training, we believe that providing an atmosphere and fostering a wellness attitude for work hardening, keeping them safe in the workplace. The system we have set up here, you can see our facility, they can work in-house and they can work on their personal time. And the balance comes in with mentoring from myself, exposing weaknesses physically, you know, what should they be working on, their cardiovascular training, their stability, their balance, their flexibility. You know, I think we focus on the work hardening thing. What we're trying to do is we're trying to reduce the injuries that are occurring on the job. If someone gets hurt on a job, obviously that's lost time. They're spending time at home. They're on workman's comp. That impacts their families, you know, tremendously. The families are watching these men and women take pride in their physical wellness and their physical being, and I think as a father, I think that's just mentorship. If my children are watching me do all of this wellness, that's going to have a positive impact on them as well as my spouse.
Based in Marquette, Upper Peninsula Health Plan has been engaged in advancing the health and well-being of the communities they serve. UPHP knows there is no better place to start to fulfill that mission than with their own employees. Their wellness committee organizes fun wellness events and challenges throughout the year and provides education that focuses on physical, mental, emotional, social, and financial health. They are empowering their employees to take charge of their own health and by extension, the health of their families and community.
My name is Melissa Holmquist. I'm the CEO for Upper Peninsula Health Plan. We believe we need to walk the walk and talk the talk. We know that employees are happier when they're healthier and really want to make sure that we have an organization that really truly believes in our employees and helps promote wellness and nutrition. We believe our wellness program has had a big impact on our employees. We continue to promote work-life balance, being healthy, getting outside. We're taking advantage of Michigan's natural resources and really just promoting a company culture of leading a healthy, happy, active lifestyle.
The Health Star Award recognizes the person who has demonstrated a sustained lifestyle transformation as part of overcoming a profound health challenge. By adopting healthy lifestyle changes, this person also serves as a role model to others. Following the birth of her fourth child at age 40, Amy DiStefano was tired, constantly nauseated, and felt like a huge weight was always pressing on her chest. Eventually, she was diagnosed with cardiomyopathy and congestive heart failure and nearly died. Her downward spiral continued. She had to stop breastfeeding and was stressed because there were so many people counting on her, her family, children, and students. Around this time, her marriage fell apart and the weight piled on, which again put her life in risk. Her doctor challenged her to find a way to lose the weight. Then a friend encouraged her to enter a 5K. She agreed and began to exercise.
I'm Amy DiStefano. I'm from Ira, Michigan, and I'm a teacher consultant at Anchor Bay High School.
Following the birth of my fourth child at age 40, I began not feeling well. Eventually, I was diagnosed with congestive heart failure and cardiomyopathy, and I was at risk for a sudden cardiac event. My cardiologist was concerned that the weight gain was hard on my heart. My life depended on me losing weight. He challenged me to lose 10, and I lost 30. My best friend knew that I was struggling to lose weight at the time, and he challenged me to run a 5K with him at the end of that summer. I couldn't even run a mile or one time around the track. Eventually, I got better, and now I participate in 5Ks, 10Ks, half marathons, triathlons, and I'm scheduled to run the Detroit Free Press International Marathon next October.
I know firsthand how overwhelming it can be to start a fitness routine. So when I talk to people, I encourage them just to start small, to move more every day. Walking is great. Those are some of the things that I tell them. Don't get discouraged, just move and start small.
After graduating from the University of Detroit Mercy with a degree in social work, native Detroiter Tamika Kelly landed her dream job with the state of Michigan. Even with her accomplishments, she felt a sense of unworthiness because of her weight. Her doctor recommended gastric bypass surgery. Knowing she had to make a serious change to her lifestyle, Tamika tried diet plans, exercise videos, skipping meals, you name it. When she hit 339 pounds, she felt broken physically and mentally. She decided to start the North Central Walkers and with a few co-workers begin walking 3 miles a day during their lunch breaks. Her sisters Tashia and Tamia took her to meet their personal trainer, Milshia Smith, who committed to Tamika without judgment. Tamika began to attend classes 5 days a week, doing cardio and strength training.
My name is Tamika Kelly. I'm from Detroit, Michigan, and I'm a social worker for the state of Michigan. I found the courage because I prayed a lot. I prayed and never gave up faith that there was something out there for me. And also, my family, they were losing weight and I wanted to join. I started preparing my own meals. I gave up pop, I gave up juice, and I limited my sugar intake. My advice I would give to others who are struggling with their health is to never give up, stay consistent, stay focused, obtain an accountability partner, and as long as you have breath, never give up on yourself.
After surviving open heart surgery in his 30s and taking medications for blood pressure, anxiety, pain, and a myriad of other ailments, including an eating disorder and self-esteem issues, Matt Laura knew it was time to get his life turned around. With the support of a good friend, he began lifting weights 2 days a week. He quickly realized that wasn't going to be enough and took up running for the first time in his life. He is also a musician and teacher, instructing hundreds of students in his choir class at Dearborn Schools. As a musician, he knows what it takes to practice to become proficient and has applied this regime to his health.
My name is Matt Laura and I live in Jackson and I'm the director of choirs at Fordson High School in Dearborn. I've had a few health challenges in my life. The big one was I had open heart surgery a few years ago to repair a valve. I struggled with my weight and with an eating disorder for about 30 years. Truthfully, most of the courage that I got came from the people who supported me, who saw what I was doing and who built me up and wouldn't let me fail on days when I did fail, because there are a lot of those days. Family, friends, students who really supported me, gave me courage to do the things that I needed to do. I think the best advice that I can give to other people is that it's never too late. You can start with something small, just get out there and do it, but always challenge yourself. My first run was just a couple hundred feet and it really hurt a lot and it took me a couple days to overcome it, but then I set a goal of running a mile. And then each goal has to be bigger than the other one, but it always has to be something that seems impossible. Find me, I'm on Instagram, find me. Like, you wanna run? Yep, I'll run. You wanna run a mile? I'll run a mile. And just, you know, find other people who have that same, that sort of like-minded desire to just be better.
The Perennial Award recognizes Michigan's most seasoned citizens, those who maintain an active lifestyle combined with healthy eating to enhance their overall wellness. Through this comprehensive, all-encompassing approach to living, they also serve as a role model for their community. Meet Brian and Dory Barkey. In 96, Brian joined the CREM Festival of Races as a group leader and volunteer coordinator. Dory joined CREM, directing their training program. Under their leadership, the program grew 10 times over and was recognized as the largest training program for a single event in the world. Since then, they've been committed to hosting community walking and running groups and have also created a community through social media. They believe in supporting others, so they do not have to be alone in their personal quest for fitness.
Hey, my name is Brian Barkey.
My name is Dory Barkey, and I'm from Flint, Michigan. I think it's important to maintain a healthy lifestyle because I have a daughter and I have grandchildren and I want to be around for them. I want to live a long time.
I started out running by myself, and then I started meeting friends doing this work, and sooner or later the friendships began to grow. My group focus in this activity began to grow. Now I run exclusively with groups of people who like to do the same thing. That's my favorite. And what I like to tell people who are thinking about getting active is that the first step is the hardest. After that, it's all like running downhill.
Meet Lizzie Burt. She is a wife, mother, registered nurse, culinary artist, endurance athlete, author, and mentor. Awarded Masters Champion at the USA Triathlon Nationals and Ironman Triathlon World Championship, she has also competed in 3 Boston Marathons and 8 Ironman World Championships. Today, she continues to win road races and open water swim races. Lizzie attributes much of her success to her coach, Lou Kidder, and his late wife, Karen McKeachy. An avid volunteer in the running community and advocate for safe places to train, she gives her time and expertise to Girls on the Run and the Here Around Waterloo Pathways Initiative. Lizzie is dedicated to the practice of yoga and knows that part of living her best life includes healthy eating. She has co-authored cookbooks and shares her skills at the University of Michigan's Food for Life Kitchen, where she teaches healthy cooking skills. When it comes to healthy living, Lizzie has found balance and has found her gift in giving back to others.
My name is Lizzie Burt. I am from Ann Arbor, Michigan. I share my passion for fitness. It's not only just the physical exterior part of working out, but actually what you put into your body. And along with 2 colleagues, I have an online cookbook through the mHealthy program at the University of Michigan. And we are constantly updating that to keep it current, to keep delicious recipes on the site that will give people an opportunity to prepare easy, really good meals for their families. Some advice I'd give to fellow Michiganders is find something that you are comfortable doing and that you will be able to continue to do.
Meet Fred Price. He is a husband, father, teacher, athlete, and consultant. For 37 years, Fred worked in Livonia Public Schools as a teacher, district administrator, and assistant director for health, physical education, art, music, and athletics, as well as a basketball and track and field coach, retiring in 2003. Today, Fred shares his expertise with Wayne State University, Eastern Michigan University, Detroit Healthy Youth, W.K. Kellogg Foundation, Michigan Department of Community Health, Michigan Surgeon General, and the Centers for Disease Controls and Prevention. He consults, promotes, and presents the exemplary physical education curriculum known as EPIC to physical education teachers statewide. He also gives his time to Northville Hills Golf Club, Ford Field, and works as the Media Center Security Manager for the last 13 Super Bowls. It would be fair to say, through his steadfast dedication to health and fitness, Fred's lifetime of work in front of the classroom and behind the scenes has and continues to influence Michiganders to live a healthy life.
My name is Fred Price, and I'm from Northville, Michigan. Maintaining a healthy lifestyle is important because you want to do things that maybe you haven't done up to this point, And if you're incapacitated by the fact that you can't get around, maybe you're really extremely overweight, the healthy lifestyle just allows you to enjoy life. I have shared my passion for living a healthy lifestyle with others by being part of the Detroit Healthy Youth Initiative, which is sponsored by Wayne State University and the Michigan Fitness Foundation, cooperating with that. And we reach students in health and physical education classes. And it was a tremendous experience. As educators, it's our responsibility to at least make it available to them and present it the best we can so that they'll pick it up and stay with it. If they choose not to, then we've done our part anyhow.
Named after the first chair of Michigan Fitness Foundation, Dr. Charles T. Kunzelman's impact on the arena of physical activity is known around the world. A celebrated educator and author, his book, They Accepted the Challenge, is a collection of stories about people who have pursued a life of physical activity despite great obstacles. The award recognizes an individual that has triumphed over adversity to become physically fit, and in doing so, has created a sustainable lifestyle for themselves while giving back to their community by serving as a role model to others. Caleb Conklin was labeled as a slow learner and struggled with severe ADHD that went undiagnosed until high school. During that time, his parents divorced and his mother died from a brain tumor. To detach from the emotional trauma, he turned to alcohol. A decade later, unable to hold a job, the grief and pain became overwhelming and he considered suicide. Through grace, his life was spared, and with the support of his father and a team of professionals, he addressed his alcoholism.
Hi, my name is Caleb Conklin. I am currently a manager at Nuevo Fitness Club in Nuevo, Michigan. 2012, I had reached rock bottom. I had put a gun to my head, and in that instance, the Lord had spoke to me right then and there, and with his guidance, I admitted myself within hours to rehab, and that started the process of dealing and getting to the root of my addictions, anxieties, mental illness, rejections, etc. And at that start, that's when I was able to start the process of recovering of my mind and body. I love my club, the Nuevo Fitness Club. We do 5 to 6 events. Golf outings, cornhole tournaments, Too Damn Tough, powerlifting, among others, and we raise money for veterans, for the public schools, for the child abuse and neglect in the greater Nuevo area. The advice I have for others who are struggling is own it, fight for it. Every single person that you see anywhere is going through something. You can either choose freedom in life or self-pity and rejection. It's up to you and it's your choice. But to give a compliment to somebody and to brighten and lighten their day is the most contagious thing, in my opinion, on this planet.
After giving birth to her 2 healthy children, Lottie's 3rd pregnancy ended with a late miscarriage. The loss triggered severe depression. A dear friend found a way to reach her. Knowing she was an avid Disney fan, she introduced her to Get Moving by encouraging her to participate in a Run Disney event. Lottie agreed and began to train. She felt her emotional well-being improving with every mile. Upon learning that she was pregnant, doctors cautioned her against running, so she spent the entire pregnancy with her feet up, researching and learning all she could about running. Within weeks of delivery, Lottie laced up her shoes. For the last 5 years, Lottie has participated in 25 half marathons, 2 full marathons, and countless other races of varying distances. She runs in the sun, rain, and snow from Michigan to Florida to California.
My name is Lottie Ferguson and I'm from Flint. I think the barriers and challenges came first. My husband and I had two very healthy daughters, and we decided to try for another baby, but something went wrong with that pregnancy, and it ended in a late miscarriage. I felt like I was alone. I retreated from society. I did not want to be around people. My children didn't understand why I was so sad. As a mother, you know that your first instinct is to protect and nurture that child, and I felt like with the loss of the baby that I had failed. And so I knew I needed to get some help, and part of that help came in the form of running. The realization I had to let me know that I was on the right path was joining a training group for a local 10-mile race, the CREM. You know, along those 15 weeks of training with other people, you get to know them. We talked about our stories, we shared our stories, and that group of ladies encouraged me like none other. Some of those ladies are still my good friends to this day, and now as a training group leader, I have the opportunity to inspire and encourage others who are wanting to run. And the advice that I have for others who may be struggling is not to be afraid to ask for help. There is huge stigma around depression and mental health and the ability to ask for help. Asking for help is a sign of strength and courage. And by all means, if you need help, get help. Talk to someone, get the help that you need. Choose physical fitness. In my case, it worked to help keep me emotionally strong.
Since he was a teenager, Jason Parks has been battling alcohol addiction. In 2016, he got sober and a fresh start. He also ran his first trail marathon and was amazed to discover that many trail and ultra marathon runners have found running a positive outlet that helped them to stay sober. Since then, he has dedicated his efforts to help others fight the battle of addiction through running. To date, Jason has completed 3 marathons, 4 50Ks, and multiple long distance running races.
My name is Jason Parks, and I'm the president and founder of Egress Endurance. So my aha moment was after battling alcoholism for about 15 years. I knew I needed to make the decision to do something about my life, otherwise I was going to lose a lot that I worked for, if not my life.
So September 12, 2016, I finally found sobriety and made the steps to start changing my life.
I knew I was on the right path when I found sobriety and then found an awesome outlet in the running and recovery community. As I found trail and ultra running to be a positive outlet for my life, I really wanted to do something to show others the positive outlet I had found. So that led to the creation of my company, Egress Endurance, and then also the running project, 4 for the Sober, which I committed to running 4 miles every day for a year to support those who were fighting addiction.
So the advice I'd have for other people who are struggling, especially with addiction, is one, to realize that you're not alone in this fight, to take it one day at a time, that if you can win each day, you can ultimately win the battle with addiction if you just take it one day at a time.
The Director's Champion for Health Award honors the person that goes beyond programming and into the systems that create the structures in which we work, live, and play. Through their work, they improve the lives and health outcomes for Michigan's most vulnerable populations. Nominated by friends, family, and colleagues, finalists are selected by a panel of judges from Michigan Fitness Foundation and the Michigan Department of Health and Human Services. Born in the South, and reared in an urban community, Regina Hardy had to overcome a great deal of adversity. She believes it was that adversity that taught her the importance of service. For the past 16 years, she serves the underserved. As a campus security police officer, leading the Eyes and Ears Patrol programs and vehicle patrols for Detroit Public Schools Community District Police Department. Grounded in inclusionary growth and community trust, she expanded on this work, becoming the Safe Routes to School program manager to secure funding and create safe environments for kids to walk and bike every day across Detroit.
My name is Regina Hardy. I'm an officer with Detroit Public Schools Community District Police Department, and I'm from Detroit, Michigan. Some of the work that I've done to help people to make healthier choices is by coordinating efforts in our local school community. I've, along with other officers, go into school populations and we teach children how to make healthier snack choices along with their parents. We provide information on how to do bike rodeos, how to increase walking, how to increase biking, and we just provide support to those local communities to assure that they have the research and the materials they need to make healthier choices. My work allowed me to have empathy because of my own personal experiences. So when I go out into the community and I coordinate with the City of Detroit's Health Department, our concentration is on educating our local population on how to be more fit and more healthy.
Growing up in Detroit in the 60s, Joanne McCullum understands barriers. With equal measures of energy, hope, passion, and activism, she has made it her life's mission to create a better quality of life for everyone in her community. As a community organizer and executive board member of the New West Willow Neighborhood Association in Ypsilanti, she has championed efforts to create a new neighborhood consciousness around healthy eating and physical activity.
My name is Joanne McCullum. I'm from Detroit, Michigan, and I'm the president of the New West Willow Neighborhood Association. To help people make healthy choices, I've enhanced the use of the community garden. We redesigned it. I got together with some residents, with the Washtenaw County Public Health, and we worked on the garden to make it more appetizing to people. And it was very successful because as soon as the vegetables were ready to harvest, they would come and get them. So before, they kind of rotted on the vines or whatever. But now, people come, they're waiting for the garden to start up again. I believe that you can have the quality of life no matter where you live. Some of us have to work a little bit more at it, but that's okay. We can have it. It's very possible.
Serving 28 years as senior counsel to the Senate Natural Resources and Environmental Affairs, Outdoor Recreation Committees, and Republican Caucus in general, Bob Wilson worked on legislation that amended every part of Michigan's Natural Resources and Environmental Protection Act and worked on the development of the Michigan Trailways Act, Great Lakes Compact, Recreation Passport Program, Ballast Water Laws, Electronic Waste Recycling, and Land Use Laws. Next, he took a position as the executive director of the Michigan Trails and Greenways Alliance, helping guide the opening of the Great Lake to Lake Trails Route No. 1, the state's longest destination trail. Working with friend and trail philanthropist Mike Levine, he created a statewide history-telling scholarship program for Michigan Trails, then worked with DNR to launch the state's new water trail designation and Pure Michigan's Trails program. He was the organization's chief advocate for key statutory changes to Michigan's trail law, including passage of e-bike legislation and changes to the Michigan Trailways Act that further enabled local trail development and helped secure a $3 million legislative appropriation for the Fred Meyer White Pine Trail. Today, Bob is an instructor at Michigan State University teaching environmental law, environmental policy, and Michigan trail law and policy. He serves as a trail volunteer for Meridian Township, is a board member of the Friends of Ingham County Parks, and was recently named by the governor as chairman of the Michigan Trails Advisory Council. A triathlete, Bob has completed multiple marathons, is an accomplished open water swimmer and cyclist. Much of his outdoor time is spent with his family and their three dogs. Bob says that he has been privileged to lead a life that merges his personal beliefs with his professional career. He stresses the importance of conserving our natural resources for sustainable and equitable access for all Michigan citizens, as well as the important role we all need to play in our government. Bob Wilson is a visionary who has dedicated his life to getting things done for the people of Michigan. The Lifetime Achievement Award is named by Dr. Vern Seifeld as Director of the Institute for the Study of Youth Sports at Michigan State University. Dr. Seifeld provided leadership, scholarship, and outreach that transformed the face of youth sports by putting child development and positive health behaviors before winning. Selected by the Governor's Council and Michigan Fitness Foundation Board, the recipient of the 2020 Vern Seifeld Lifetime Achievement Award is Dr. Kimberly Dawn Wisdom. Appointed by Governor Granholm, Dr. Wisdom was Michigan's and the nation's first state-level Surgeon General. She was then appointed by President Obama to serve on the Advisory Group on Prevention, Health Promotion, and Integrative and Public Health. Today, she is the Senior Vice President of Community Health and Equity and Chief Wellness and Diversity Officer at Henry Ford Health System, a board-certified emergency medicine physician and chair of the Gao and Lois Warden Endowment on Multicultural Health. She also serves on the faculty of University of Michigan's Department of Medical Education and is an adjunct professor to the School of Public Health. Her work focuses on health disparities, health care equity, infant mortality, maternal and child health, chronic disease, physical inactivity, unhealthy eating habits, and tobacco use. She works collaboratively with school districts, faith-based organizations, and the business community.
I'm Dr. Kimberly Dawn Wisdom. I'm at Henry Ford Health System, and I serve as Senior Vice President of Community Health and Equity and the Chief Wellness and Diversity Officer. I'm very delighted to be honored with the Seifeld Lifetime Achievement Award, and I want to thank the Governor's Council on Physical Fitness, Health, and Sports for this tremendous honor. I think it's so important to inspire people to be healthier because our health is our greatest wealth. You can have all of the professional education, all of the degrees, all of the financial resources, but if you don't have your health, you can't enjoy those. You can't enjoy your family. You can't serve, you can't worship. That's why it's so important to inspire people and to try to practice the healthiest behaviors possible, because that's our greatest wealth. Well, throughout my career, I've had the privilege to work with some amazing people, and I've had tremendous teams. And working collaboratively with those teams, we together have been able to accomplish quite a few in terms of programs and practices. So several, we've had efforts that relate to infant mortality reduction. We've had efforts that have focused on improving youth and youth leadership development. We've had programs focused on seniors called Knock and Check to address social isolation. We've had programs that have focused on being healthier, such as Michigan Steps Up. And we've had programs that have focused on, for instance, African American men, the AIM High, the African American Initiative for Male Health Improvement. But my professional work, I have always strived to have it make an impact in Michigan and beyond. So the work in Michigan, when I served as Surgeon General for the state of Michigan, with, again, a fabulous team of people, we're able to develop a program called Michigan Steps Up, where we wanted people to move more, eat better, and not use tobacco products. And we were able to launch that in 5 different sectors across the state and see change occur in terms of health and well-being. In terms of impact outside of the state, our infant mortality effort called WIN Network Detroit, we developed it in Michigan, we developed it with many partners, and just about a year or so ago, we were able to actually have that program replicated in another city. So not only is there now a WIN Network Detroit or Women Inspired Network Detroit, but now there's a WIN Network Cleveland. What inspires me personally to be healthier is that I know I can't serve the people that I want to serve if I'm not healthy. So whether it's my family, my husband, my children, being all that I can be for them, but also I want to be all that I could be for my community, for the health system that I work for, I have to be healthy in order to serve and achieve the goals that I endeavor to achieve. Health is our number one wealth. I have sweets and do things in moderation, but realizing how important our health is and protecting our health is everything, because our health is indeed our greatest wealth.